So how did I join synthesis? Well, it's kind of the same for almost everyone in our team. I was part of an FRC team, and then I found synthesis through FIRST.
I was actually a software engineer on my robotics team and wanted more experience in development. So I applied to the internship, and turned out actually a lot of the other interns came from a variety of backgrounds in FIRST, from electrical to mechanical to even business.
But since we all have that common background with FRC, it's really easy to come together as a team and work with other interns. I've made a lot of good friendships here over the past few summers.
What do I like about the synthesis internship? I like the fact that we kind of work as our own product team. We have multiple development teams, we have marketing interns, management interns, and design interns, which is really nice because we get to control almost every aspect of synthesis.
It's almost like working in a startup within the giant company that is Autodesk. We have a small team of interns working on maintaining our product year-round and providing support to students. And then in the summer, we have our big 10-week internship program where there are normally 10 to 15 students who work on different parts of our simulation system.
Our goal is really based around creating software for students built by other students. Synthesis came about because we saw a need for testing while the robot was physically inaccessible in our own teams. And another thing is all of our software is open source so that anyone can add features they find necessary.
We try to work with the community as much as possible, and that's actually one of my favorite parts about synthesis is running workshops with other students so that we can get direct feedback on the features that we're implementing.
Are there any features I want to talk about? I think one of the most notable features is actually our driver practice mode. It's one of the ways that my team uses the most because it gives us an idea of how the field is and a rough estimation of what it feels like to drive an actual robot.
The emulation feature is also something we've worked on for a while now. The emulation feature mostly provides the opportunity to iron out bugs. It allows users to run their own code on a virtual robot, and I'm particularly proud of it because as a software engineer on my FRC team, I rarely got time to test on the actual robot. So I hope that this will be helpful to other people who are in the same situation I was.
Adapting for 2020, well, it's been a crazy year.
I think the biggest change was our work environment. Since we went completely virtual, we couldn't chat over the coffee machine anymore. But the full-time employees at Autodesk were really nice, and they went out of their way to still schedule time to meet with us and teach us about the products and tools that they use.
It's great to have so many mentors around that work with products that we use all the time on our team. I've actually learned so much about Fusion and Inventor despite not having any CAD experience in the past.
And working with full-time employees has shown me a lot about different opportunities that the company holds.
As far as our software goes, since we're building something that was based on providing a virtual experience from the get-go, we spent most of our time ironing out the features we've been working on.
We updated our field exporter so that teams can use it for the new 2021 Game Design Challenge, and we've updated our emulation software to make it easier to test code virtually.
One thing we've done is to try and make it as easy as possible to go from Fusion and Inventor into Synthesis.
There's also tons of tutorials on how you can use Fusion and Inventor to design robots and fields, as well as how you can take those robots and fields from Fusion and Inventor and port them directly into Synthesis.
As students, educators, mentors, and even hobbyists, you can get access to the Autodesk software for free, including Inventor and Fusion 360. We recommend getting started with Fusion 360 to get started in designing your robots, your own FRC game for the 2021 Game Design Challenge, and to compete in other First at Home challenges. Fusion 360 is cloud-based, which makes collaboration still possible to continue working at home as a team, just like you would in your pits.
We are excited to see if more teams will take the opportunity to build full CAD models of their robots and use synthesis to bring them to life. Since building actual robots may still not be possible for some teams, this is a great time to focus on CAD and build that skill.
Wherever you may be in the world, and however you may be fighting this world pandemic, most of us still have the power to stay connected in one form or another.
As you prepare for your first at-home competitions, let's work together to explore new ideas, innovate new methods of connecting, and learn new ways to power the future with this year's 2021 Infinite Recharge Build Season.